He has the ball. He gets it up to the 32-yard line before being stopped by the Saints. So Mendon will start off with the ball, first and 10 at their own 32-yard line. A pretty good kick by Krzyzewski, 50 yards, a 22-yard return. Coach Pearson, one of the things he worries about is the play of his special teams today. He wants that to be done well if they're to win.
Well, we've had excellent ones all year, Don, as you know, and of course this is going to be a big factor in this if we can keep field position and that sort of thing. And right now, here we go on D.
First and 10, Mendon. Hand off, Eric George. 2 yards to the 34-yard line. It is going to be a deceptive offense, this Wishbone offense. Toit on the tackle for the Saints.
Well, Toit had a great game last week, Don. Player of the game, and they're starting right out. And of course, the defensive ends are going to be a real big key here, because when you option, they're optioning the end over there, and it's a lot's going to depend on their play, the outcome of whether Mendon's going to be able to run that Wishbone option.
Second down and 8 for the Hornets. Jones still with the ball. He's tackled by number 71 for the Saints. 77, that is, Mike Kelly. So Tim Jones on the option run gains 3 yards, and it will be 3rd and 5.
Well, they played that one well, Gus. It was just perfect. Had safety coming up there on that. We got the end goal wide on the pitch man, and so far Coach Pearson has had them ready, just doing exactly what they have to do here to stop this option.
You're listening to WMKC FM 103, voice of St. Football. The snap from center, the handoff goes to the short man up, Chris Hoss. He gets loose. He's close to a first down, and I think he has it. He was hit initially and would have been stopped short of the line, but it looks to me he does have a first down.
Oh, that was close. Oh, you had him. And not only that, but he fumbled, he bobbled the ball and almost fumbled it, but he got control of it again as Oya was slipping off his leg, and just enough to get a first down.
One of the things we said was, how will the Silver Dome affect the Saints? The Saints on defense first, but it looks as if they're ready to play football, even though they gave up a first down.
Well, it certainly does. They've done just exactly what they've had to do so far.
Snap from center, handoff, Eric George. There's a penalty flag down. I thought there was illegal procedure a play or two ago also, the one in which quarterback Jones optioned. But this time it's called immediately by the official. Let's see the indication from the official. Illegal procedure, Mendon. They do it all at Dwight's Auto Clinic on North State Street in St. Ignace. No matter what type of car trouble you may experience, Dwight's Auto Clinic can handle the job. Tune-ups, brake work, transmission mufflers, welding, and more is all available at Dwight's Auto Clinic. Make sure your vehicle's ready for the winter weather coming up. Contact Dwight's Auto Clinic on North State Street in St. Ignace. So following the 5-yard penalty, which is the first penalty of the game, it is 1st and 15 for the Hornets at their own 39-yard line. Back to pass is Jones. He's looking over the middle and open. For 25 yards and a first down deep into St. Ignace territory at the 36-yard line.
Well, they caught the same defense napping there on the backside. He rolled this way a little bit, and those corners on the backside have got to roll to the deep middle, and they just got beat a little bit right there. I see Erskine going out now, and Rich Frazier coming in.
Hornets nothing, Saints nothing. 9:22 left to go in the first quarter. The Hornets are on a drive. 1st and 10 at the 36-yard line. Still with the ball is Jones. He runs this option well. He gains about 9 yards. He's close to a first down. He was tackled by Kit Husky. 2nd down and 1 coming up for Mendon.
Well, they run that nicely, and Husky got taken in just a little bit. He took the fake up the middle, but his responsibility on that one is the quarterback coming around the end. He's going to have to get there a little bit quicker than he did right there, Don.
2nd and 1. Right now, Mendon having easy time moving the ball. The ball is at the St. Ignace 27. It's 2nd down and 1. The handoff goes to Chris Hoss. He has the first down. A gain of 3 yards. The ball now at the 24. Scott Mitchell on the tackle for the Saints. But 1st and 10. For Mendon at the 24-yard line of St. Ignace.
Well, something's got to happen right here pretty quick, Don. We're getting down in there, and they're getting into some real tough territory, and the defense has to do something right away here. We can't let them get another first down, get down in there around the 10-yard line. The things really get hard down in there, and especially early in the game when they're all pumped up. So the D, somebody's got to have a big play.
First and 10, snap from center. Handoff goes to Steve Seuss, who gets to the 18, 17, and then the 16-yard line, it appears. So a gain of 8 yards on the play for Steve Seuss, and they're running at will right now against the Saints.
Well, we've defense out there where the safety has to take that man on off tackle, and right now he's beating him to the hole, Don, so I don't know whether Coach Pearson had to make some sort of adjustment or whether he's going to have to get after those safeties there, and they have to get to the corner a little faster.
Second down and 2, the ball at the St. Ignace 16. Handoff goes to a new back, I think, in there. I didn't, number 21, who I do not have in the game, Dennis Jones. He gets 2 yards and is very close to a first down. He has it. Tackled by Glenn Gibson and Scott Mitchell. So Dennis Jones comes into the game for one play, gets 2 yards and a first down, and it's now first down and 10 for Mendon inside the 14-yard line of St. Ignace.
Well, that's what we just said we didn't want them to do, and they made it in 2 plays, so the defense is going to have to tighten up. They just can't give them 10 yards on the ground in 2 plays.
First and 10, Mendon. Handoff. Down at the 1 yard line is Mendon. Steve Seuss gains 13 yards and is down at the 1 foot line, it appears to be.
Same exact play they've been running. They just come out wide here. And right now, that was a nice crackback block on Husky. He got there a little quicker that time, but the split man came down on him and took him out right as he was getting to the man ahead of the ball, and that opened it up, and he stumbled down just short of the goal line.
First and goal to goal for Mendon inside the 1 yard line. Quarterback keeper, touchdown Mendon. 1 yard touchdown run for Tim Jones at 6:44 of the first quarter. And Mendon leads this one 6-0.
Well, we've got some defensive adjustments we have to make out there right now, Don. Of course, when you get a team gets down there right on the goal line with 3-4 plays to pop it in, that's impossible to offer the defense. So that was kind of expected right there once they got right down in there. But we're going to have to make some a lot tougher on them than that.
In to attempt the extra point. The kick is up, and the kick is no good. Off to the left. So the kick fails, and the score remains 6-0.
This is the high school goalpost in here, Don. We were told before the broadcast, it's the first time that in these playoffs they took the pro goalpost down, which are narrower, and put up the wider high school goals, but he was still wide.
Here's a reminder, the portions of today's game as well as the Player of the Week selection are being brought to you by Brown & Brown, attorneys at law, St. Ignace and Sederville. Winkleman's Clothing and Shoe Store in downtown St. Ignace is headquarters in Eastern UP for name brand apparel and footwear for every member of the family. You can put your trust in names such as Woolrich, Lee, Fire Islander, Levi, and Shippenshore, not to mention Campus, Dexter, Nike, and Kangaroo. You'll love the selection, reasonable prices, and courteous service you'll receive each and every time you shop Winkleman's Clothing and Shoe Store in downtown St. Ignace. So Mendon moves right down the field after getting the ball, chews up 8 minutes and 16 seconds of time, and scores here and leads the Saints 6-0 with 6:44 left to go in the first quarter.
Well, we've got to do some things different here, Gus. Of course, our offense is the first chance we're going to get the ball right here, and of course, we have a pretty tough offense ourselves, and by the looks of that right there, we're going to have to score a few times here in this game today, and we have to make some adjustments defensively. We just have to get those safeties to the corner faster, or of course, they could switch assignments if they had to, too, but we can't let that go on the way it is.
Reading a comment in the free press by one of the Mendon scouts, he thought this game would be extremely high scoring. I don't think it'll be quite that high, but the way Mendon moved it, I was extremely surprised. The kick goes to Matt Oya at the 25. He gets to the 30, and that's where he's down. So a 35-yard kick and a 5-yard return, and the Saints start out the ball first and 10 at their own 30-yard line.
It's not bad field position. You're always talking about get out to 30. Of course, we started at the 25, but anytime you can start to 30, you're, you know, one, two first downs and you're midfield and across. And of course, we have the big play offense too, Don. So here we go right now. Let's see if the offense is ready.
We'll see if the offense can put some points on the board. First time with the ball. Handoff goes to Steve Becker. He runs with the ball to the 35, 38, 39 yard line. So Steve Becker, a gain of 9 yards on the first play from scrimmage. The offensive line opened up a big hole on that play.
Well, we said before during the year that first down is critical. And when you can get big yards on a first down like that, second and third make pretty easy to get that first down.
Second down, one. Mendon appears to be in a 62 defense. Handoff goes to Steve Becker again. He's out to the 45 and down to the 48-yard line. A first down, St. Ignace. Another gain of 9 yards. And Steve Becker, 18 yards, two plays. The Saints moving the ball. First and 10 at their own 48-yard line.
Big holes off the right-hand side there. Both times for Becker. And, of course, he's that little hunting, picking type a runner on this. AstroTurf is going to be just great for him today.
Coach Roger Smith does not like what he sees. He calls timeout for Mendon. When you're in the market for a home, cottage, lake property, or business opportunity, let Statewide Real Estate of St. Ignace lend you a helping hand. They've been serving people just like you in this area for 29 years, handling all forms of real estate. Rely on the professional expertise of Statewide Real Estate of St. Ignace on US 2 West, 3 miles west of the bridge, George Shinsky Realtor. Phone 643-8525. That's 643-8525. Going on right now, the hottest deals on the hottest wheels at McDonald's in St. Ignace. Get super slick, super speedy Mattel Hot Wheels cars at McDonald's for just 59 cents plus tax with any food purchase. There's the Red Hot Corvette Stingray, the Big Bad Baja Breaker, the fabulous Firebird Funny Car, the Jeep CJ7, and more. 14 in all. Get the hottest deals on the hottest wheels at McDonald's in St. Ignace. Just 59 cents plus tax. One car per food item purchase at McDonald's of St. Ignace. We're back with 5:49 left to go in the first quarter. The score, Mendon 6, St. Ignace nothing. And during the defensive series for St. Ignace, our St. Ignace section was extremely quiet, but they've come to life with the first two running plays by Steve Becker.
Well, it doesn't like an offense to get things going, and of course we have a good one there, and Becker's running a couple times, first downs, and here we go again.
First and 10, St. ball at their own 48-yard line. Rich Frazier optioning this way. He gets to the 49-yard line and does not get much. It appears to be 1 yard. It'll be second and 9. You're listening to WMKC FM 103. I'm Don Gustafson, along with Rick Leedy and Bo Bradford here today from the Pontiac Silverdome. And Bo, this facility is still just a dream. I think I'm still in awe here for a little bit. I hope our players aren't.
Well, that's right. This is a beautiful place, and there's excitement building, and this is fun.
Second down, 9. St. ball at their own 49. Handoff Steve Becker to the 50, to the 45, to the 40-yard line. First down, St. Ignace. A gain of 11 yards on the play and a first down for the Saints. Their second of today. Steve Becker, 3 carries, 29 yards. He's going to town.
Oh, he is. He's got big holes over there, and he's really cutting well on this turf in here right now, Don. It looks like he's going to have a big game. And right now, here's the first offensive set out of the wing T. We've been running out of the wing I so far.
First and 10, ball at the Mendon 40. Hand off Matt Oya to the 35, to the 30-yard line, and down at the 29. Another first down for St. Ignace. 10 yards on Matt Oya's first run, and the Saints are ripping apart Mendon's defense as Mendon tore apart the Saints' defense.
Chewing up huge holes inside. That was the first time that we ran out of the wing tee with the motion man. Come back to Oya, coming back against that motion. And so far, Mendon hasn't been able to handle the Saint offense.
First and 10, ball now at the Mendon 30. Offensive showing here early. Back is Rich Frazier. He sets up the pass.
Oh.
He opened his right.
Oh.
Here he goes. Ryan Cahill on a 30-yard touchdown pass. High score is 6-6.
Oh, boy. It was a defense sucked in on that one. Frazier rolled to the right, hit Cahill wide open out there, and Shinsky was with him. Both receivers didn't have a man within 20 yards of him, Gus, and it was easy picking. And 6 on the board. Here's the extra point.
Succeed. The kick is up. The kick is good. 8-7. Hornets 6. with 4 minutes and 30 seconds left to go in the first quarter. Brian Cahill on a nice 30-yard pass from Rich Frazier. McPhee adds the extra point, and the Saints take a 7-6 lead, and you hear the Saint band playing in the background.
Oh, they are in the crowd on this side. We're sitting right above the Mendon group over here, and they're all of a sudden quiet. They were crazy about 5 minutes ago. Now all of a sudden, St. Ignace comes to life, and just a great, tremendous offensive drive there. Don, they weren't close to stopping them at any time.
The one thing that can really go right at this point for the Saints is if they can go down at this time and now hold Mendon defensively after scoring, big mo, as they call it, or momentum, will be on the side of the Saints.
Definitely, this is going to be a big series for the defense. If we can get Lee and Toit and the rest of them in there, we've got to shut Mendon down and give our offense another chance to get that ball back. And, of course, if something like that happened and we could put another one in like we just did there, then that would really stun the Mendon Hornets.
Brian Cahill's injury didn't seem to bother him as he sprinted down the far sideline.
All of a sudden, his ankle was much better, Don.
And the passing game was wide open, at least on that play. There was no one near either Cahill or Shinsky.
Well, he picked the short receiver because it was a little easier to throw, but he could have thrown deeper to Shinsky, who was wide open, too. There wasn't anyone even in the ballpark there, Don.
4 minutes, 30 seconds left in the first quarter. You're listening to the voice of Saint Football, WMKC FM 103. The kick is off. The kick goes to the 16-yard line. It's off there. It's now handed off to Eric George to the 20, to the 25, and down at the 29 or 30-yard line. As we said in the pregame, if there is any chance at all, they will try and get the ball to Eric George on the kickoff. Jarrett Sexton on the tackle for the Saints. The ball was fumbled. They turned around and handed the ball to Eric George.
Well, you like to use what you have, and of course he has the speed and they want to use him, but in doing that, the Saint kicking team has plenty of time to get downfield, and they lose an extra 5 or 10 yards, but they're hoping that with his speed he can break one eventually, so it would come out ahead in the long run.
First and 10, ball at the Mendon 30. Penalty flags all over. And we'll see what the call is. I believe it's illegal procedure, Mendon. Overall dependability is what you need in a vehicle during Northern Michigan winters. Stop by Mackinac Sales, Ford and Mercury in St. Ignace, and check out the gutsy little Ford Ranger 4x4 pickup and the tough Ford F-Series pickups. You'll find super saving prices on the Ford Ranger with all the right equipment for plenty of off-road fun. Stop in soon. Mackinac Sales, Ford and Mercury in St. Ignace, your winter driving headquarters. Following the penalty, first and 15. Handoff goes to Steve Shoup, who runs this way and gains good yardage. It was first and 15. He gets 13 of the yards back. And it'll be second and 2 coming up.
Well, they're starting out right where they left off in the last series, and they're running right off tackle here, and the safety has just not been able to get there. He's being beat to the outside right now, Don, so I don't know exactly what we're going to have to do a little more plugging there. The hole's just getting a little bit too wide off this side.
It'll be second down and 2. At the present time, Eric George is not in the ball game. Second and 2. Handoff goes to Dennis Jones, who gets to the 38 or 39. Not a first down as the defensive line made a nice play on Mendon. Paul Getson on the tackle for the Saints and Mike Kelly. So it'll be third down and 1 as Dennis Jones able to get 1 yard. We do not understand the reason Eric George is not in the ball game at the present time.
Well, that was a great defensive charge right there by our right side, and whenever they try to go up the middle, they get nothing. They have a little more running room when they've been going wide.
Third and 1. Handoff, first down, Dennis Jones. It appeared from up here that the left side of the line took off a little early, but there was no flag, and Mendon picked up a first down.
Boy, their left tackle either is one of the quickest people I've ever seen off the ball, or he's been offside about 6 times already, because he is really getting a jump right there, Don. And apparently the referee is right on the ball there, saying that he's getting off right on the hike, and he's really getting out of there fast.
Well, there was some St. Ignace mumbling in the crowd you could hear from up here. Back to pass. And the outlet pass goes to Steve Schutz. There's a penalty flag on the play. Brian Cahill made the tackle. Clipping on Mendon, so that will move him back 15 yards. The pass was complete on the short swing pass to Steve Schutz, but they'll move him back 15 yards. Your state representative, Pat Gagliardi, hopes the Saints win today and brings home that state championship to the UP. Have fun at your game and have a safe evening. If you have a problem with state government, let Pat know. Write to him, Pat Gagliardi, State Capitol, Lansing, Michigan, 48909. State Capitol, Lansing, Michigan, 48909. A big clipping penalty moves the ball back to the Mendon 29, and it'll be first down and 25, it appears to be.
Well, that was a nice play by Hardy over on this side here, Don. He read that little screen pass, and he was right there waiting for him. He had nowhere to go, and the blocker who was supposed to be there got there late, of course, and it's Hardy bringing him down. He clipped him from the backside, which cost him 15. So now they have first and long.
Only one back now in the backfield, and he gets the ball. Dennis Jones, and he's tackled right away. No, he did not fake anyone off.
Hardy.
Jim Hardy on the fine tackle. One setback was all, a definite passing situation. No gain on the play. It'll be second down and 26.
Great play by Hardy right there. He was blocked by two men. They were our defense, the same defense had shifted to the right when they came back against to the weak side. But Hardy wouldn't be moved, and he took on a blocker and made the tackle. And, of course, Lee and Mitchell were right in on top to help bring him down.
Second down, 26. A minute 15 left to go in the first quarter. Handoff goes to Steve Schutz. He doesn't get much. It appears Glenn Gibson was in on the tackle, along with Paul Getson.
Another super play by the defensive end, Don. He didn't make the tackle. That's Toyed on that side, but he was right in the backfield, squared up. That runner had nowhere to go, no chance of getting outside of him. He had to turn back to the inside, and there was a swarm of defenders right there, led by Gibson there. And right now, the defense looks like they're kind of getting this thing figured out a little bit.
1 yard for Steve Schutz, third and 24. Handoff.
Fumble
on the play. The Saints had it and lost it back to Mendon. They tried to pick up number 77, Mike Kelly, tried to pick up the ball and run with it and never got the ball. Instead, Mendon jumped back up on it, and the ball goes to the 34-yard line, and it will be fourth down and long, 21 yards to go.
Mike Kelly will be seeing that one in his dreams for quite some time to come, Don, because that ball was right in front of him, no one else around. He tried to pick it up, and they fumble a little bit, and Mendon come diving in there and got it. So we're still going to get the ball back, but it's going to cost us a few yards and field position.
The first quarter of the Pontiac Silverdome is history. The Saints lead at the end of one, 7-6. If you want to provide the utmost convenience to your patrons, remember UP Snack Foods and Very Fine Vending in St. Ignace. They can supply you with modern full-line vending service as well as quality Tom snacks. And they now introduce Star Trek satellite systems completely installed for just $2,200 plus tax. Easy term financing is available. Call 643-7562 for a free demonstration. UP Snack Foods and Very Fine Vending of St. Ignace, featuring a snack for every taste. As a reminder, this game is especially brought to you with special help by the First National Bank, as the trip to the Silverdome and the tape of the game cost a lot of money to secure, and the First National Bank helped out substantially with that. So the first quarter history. Rick, any thoughts on the first quarter before they get ready to snap it for the second quarter?
Well, this is about what we have to do. Defense has to take control and shut down that Mendon offense to give our offense the ball back, because the way we're eating up yards, all we need is to have that ball. So it's going to be a lot of pressure on the defense. Get that ball back over to Frazier and company and see if we can get down the field.
They surely moved it nicely the first time that they had the ball. And it appears as if the Saints will get it back within seconds, as in punting formation is number 41, Chris Miller. The punt is up. Brian Cahill has it at the 35. Hands off to Becker at the 33. He loses three more yards. It was covered beautifully by Mendon.
Great coverage right there. They tried a little reverse there on the handoff that we've done during the year that's been so effective, but they had people downfield so fast that just as KO was handing it off, he was getting hit, which turned out could have been a little bit dangerous right there, but Erskine hung on to it, but there was nowhere, or Becker that is, and there was nowhere for him to go. So we're still starting good field position down at the 30.
First and 10, Saints at the 30-yard line. They lead here 7-6, 11:38 left to go in the first half. You're listening to WMKC, FM 103. Handoff goes to Brian Cahill, who gets 4 yards out to the 34-yard line. That's Brian's first run from scrimmage today. Of course, he caught the lone touchdown. A pass from Rich Frazier 30 yards out. So a 4-yard gain on the play makes it 2nd and 6 as the ball has to go to just about the 41. Let's call that 3 yards instead and call it 2nd and 7 for the Saints. The snap from center. The handoff to Cahill. Oh, Frazier has it himself. He fooled us up here. And Frazier makes a nice move and gets to the 39-yard line, a gain of 5. It'll be 3rd down and about 2.
Well, that was a nice play right there, Don. That almost popped for more. We had the cornerback out here. We had good option. And Peter pitched that ball to Becker. I'm not so sure that he wouldn't still be running. But we had some good yards up inside as Rich turned up with it. And right now the offense has 3rd and short.
3rd down and 1. Frazier on the quarterback keeper. 1st down, Saints. 3 yards and a 1st down. Plenty of room up the middle as the center gets and opened a big hole for Frazier.
He's a big boy in there, and he knows how to block. And all they got to do is follow Getson. And, of course, they got some big guards in there, too. And that's an easy way to get a yard or two. And, of course, we usually get about 3 when we do that. And, of course, we've seen them break that particular play right there over the year, too. So here we go again.
I smell a pass coming up shortly for the Saints. We'll see. 1st and 10. Handoff. Matt Oya running room, 45. He breaks the tackle. He might go to the 40, 35, and 30 finally brought out of bounds at the 28-yard line. Matt Oya on a nice run. There is an injured Mendon player on the field, it appears to be. But nonetheless, Matt Oya, a 28-yard run and a 1st down for the Saints.
Nice play. They start coming this way. They trapped it back to the opposite side again, and Oya was wide open. He nice fake to the inside, got around the cornerback. The safety come over, run him out of bounds, and then he was jumped on out of bounds. There was an obvious 15-yard piling on penalty, but the ref over there never threw it, Don.
Shaking up on the play is number 79, Todd Haynes of Mendon. He goes out of the ball game. So the Saints, moving the ball well, have 1st and 10 at the Mendon 29. Handoff, Steve Becker, 2 yards to the 27-yard line. They mark his knee down at the 28, so we'll call it 1 yard for Steve Becker, who now has 4 carries for 30 yards. And Matt Oya, 2 carries for 38 yards. The 2 halfbacks are killing Mendon.
Well, they are, and Mendon now has gone from that 62 we saw earlier to a straight up 44 now, Don. Apparently they're getting trapped too easy out of that 6, and they've got some people off the line now a little bit.
2nd and 9. Hand off Steve Becker. Nothing. He gets 1 out of a something that should have been nothing. He squirmed his way to the 27-yard line, and that play is suddenly being stopped by Mendon.
Well, with those 4 linebackers in there, they all have time to read and move a little bit, and it's when they stack in there, too, it's a little tougher for the offensive line to get to them. So right now they're stacking up the inside and the off tackle, so we're going to have to go wide, and, of course, 3rd now, we'll probably go to the air.
And a nice defensive play by number 10, Randy Cleveland. He hit Andy Brown as the ball was coming right to him as the ball touched him. It looks to me like a good defensive play.
You can't ask for better timing than that, because he hit him just as his hands were getting on the ball. And, of course, Andy had no chance whatsoever. Bo is moaning over here. He's saying, you guys are crazy. That was pass interference. But you didn't get the call, Bo.
We'll let the replay decide for yourself. You watch Monday Night Football on Straits Community Television. Going for it on 4th and 8 are the Saints. Big pitch. Hand off, Oya, 1 yard, that's it. The ball will go over to Mendon. I really thought a pass might have worked.
Well, Pearson is thinking that Mendon is expecting a pass too, and he thought maybe the little draw with the big pass rush would do it, but there was somebody there waiting, and now we're on defense to see if we can turn him back again.
So Mendon gets the ball back, first and 10 at their own 26-yard line. Mendon scored on their opening possession. The Saints came down and scored on their opening possession. Since that time, both teams stymied. The score 7-6 here, Saints over the Hornets with 8:25 left to go in the first half. Back to pass. Jones almost intercepted by Husky and Frazier together, but as they tip the ball, number 44, Joe Haas, might have come up with a reception and it would have been TD for Mendon.
Well, that was close. As you say, it was good defensive coverage. Both people were right there, and they just tipped it, and of course 44 there, Joe Haas, as you mentioned, was behind him, and he almost got the rebound and went on in, but good pass coverage in the backfield.
Second and 10 for Mendon from their own 26-yard line. There's penalty flag on the play. It came from the umpire, so I'm going to guess that somebody moved on the offensive line. Let's see. That's what it is. Fall is typically a time for sprucing up your home. If new floor coverings are part of this year's project, Superior Floor Coverings of St. Ignace is the place to shop. They offer a wide range of brand name carpets, linoleums, and tiles, and provide expert installation. Let them help you with your home redecorating this year. Superior Floor Coverings, 440 North State Street, St. Ignace. Phone 643-7477. That's 643-7477. Mendon hurting themselves on penalties, now have 30 yards in penalties. Saints still have no penalties. Second and 15. Still with the ball is Jones. He options upfield. He gains 3 yards on the play. And it'll be third and 12, but it is really becoming a question from up here. We're a long ways away from the field where Eric George, their star running back, is.
Well, I'm not sure. I don't think we've seen him, Gus, since he's ran that kickoff back. But that's okay. I hope he's not hurt or anything, but we'll go without him in there for a while. And right now the defense is playing tough. And Hardy over there again turned that in. They wanted to pitch it and try to go outside of Hardy, but they just can't do it out there. He's playing a whale of a game.
To be honest, I don't spot Eric George on the sideline. Third and 12. Jones with an option. He's got lots of running room this way. He's got a first down and more. This Tim Jones is a great ball player. He runs the wishbone, they say, as well as anyone. A big pickup. A first down on a 23-yard gain by Tim Jones.
Well, I'm not exactly sure what happened there on our defense, as we're seeing it on the replay. Kelly came down and tackled the fullback like he's supposed to, but there I see 73 chasing Toit from behind, and I don't know whether he was outside, he had to turn it in, or whether he's supposed to get that quarterback, but something didn't go right, and they had a big gainer.
First and 10, Mendon now with the ball at their own 48-yard line. Handoff goes to Dennis Jones, who gets to the St. 46-yard line, a gain of 5 yards. Brian Toit on the tackle. So Mendon now again moving offensively.
Boy, you don't like to see that, Don, when you have them down in a big hole and they had third and long, and here they squeaked out of it, and now they're going to get at midfield. So that was a super chance that we let by on the defense.
Second down, 5. Again, strange movement on the offensive line. The pitch was bad, and it's caught by Mendon, but not before the Saints get in there and tackle him. It looks to be for a 1 yard loss as number 67, Jim Hardy, in on the tackle. They do lose 1 yard on the play. The pitch was what happened actually to Mendon's falling apart on that play, but Jim Hardy also had something to do with it.
Well, he is playing one heck of a game over there on our defensive left side, because Mendon wants to run right, and they just can't go anywhere with Hardy over there. He took on a blocker again. Now they haven't made a solo tackle, so he's having just a great game over there. He's getting a lot of help inside, which is forcing him out there.
Eric George not in the game. Third and 6. Back to pass. And rushed heavily and caught by Kelly. And Sackaroo. Also in on the tackle, number 72, Paul Getson. So a big loss on the play for Mendon, and the ball is now back at the Mendon 43-yard line. So a loss on that play of 10 yards will make it fourth down and 15.
Well, the initial rush was by Caveman Lee, who put all kinds of pressure on him. He had to break out of the pocket where he wanted to go and right into the arms of Kelly, and then up from the inside comes Getson, cleaning things up. So just a great rush by the interior of the line on that one.
Fourth down and 15. In the game is Chris Miller to punt for Mendon. He's standing at his own 31. The bobble snaps, almost blocked by the Saints. Brian Cahill gets it on the run of the 27-30, 35-40. Out of bounds at the 44. Those line drive punts are the ones that can be returned, and that's what happened there. Real good position, first and 10 at their own 44.
Well, that's excellent field position. They're just shy of the 45, and of course that was a key. One of the keys to that was the rush by the defensive line. The kicker had to hurry it. He got off a wobbly one, and Cahill took her on the run and had a good return.
First and 10, Saints have the ball. They lead here 7-6 with 4:56 left to go in the first half. We're at the Pontiac Silverdome. Back to pass. Rick Frazier open is Brian Cahill downfield. Instead, he's going to run with it. He gets to the 48 and steps out of bounds. But again, it appears that the passing game was open.
Well, there was kind of tough to see there, but we had Cahill and then we had Brown coming across. So we had two or three receivers over here, but there was one defender kind of standing in the middle guarding all three of them. So if we can get our patterns a little wider somehow over there, Gus, we certainly would have had someone open.
Do you think that possibly being at this level, probably 100 feet in the air, might help us see the passing game a little bit better?
I'm sure that Frazier doesn't see as exactly the same angle as we do.
Second down and 6, ball on the Saint 48. Handoff goes to Matt Oya. He's tackled for a 2-yard loss behind the line of scrimmage by number 79, Todd Haynes of Mendon. And it'll be now 3rd and 9 for the Saints following the 3-yard loss by Oya.
Well, again, we tried some kind of a roll this way and tried to give it to Oya going back on a trap going against the flow, but too much penetration by the Mendon line and nothing there. So now we have 3rd and 9 again, 3rd and long. We're out of the shotgun.
Out of the shotgun, 3rd and 9. Our man wasn't set. There's a penalty flag on the play. It was tipped. It's incomplete. Man in motion by St. Ignace. Steve Becker was never set, and that's what the penalty is going to be. I'm sure it'll be declined. Mendon will get the ball probably on a punt upcoming. With the longer evenings approaching, you'll be spending more and more time inside. That's when it's important to have a TV that won't let you down, like an RCA. Stop by TNT Electronics in St. Ignace and check into their line of dependable RCA TVs. There's a model and price to suit every need and every budget. And you'll get expert service after the sale from TNT Electronics of St. Ignace, your area RCA television dealer. So 7-6 following the decline penalty by Mendon. The Saints are forced with a 4th and 9, and I think they'll punt it away.
Well, they have to, and there's only 4 minutes left in half. We get them down there in good field position. Defense holds them and turn the ball back. We still have time before half to try it again.
Back to punt is Steve Becker. Buzz Griffin catches it at the 20. He runs right to the 23,
oh,
and he's nailed by number 80, Jerry Colgrove. That's good for a 35-yard punt and a 3-yard return. Mendon takes over the ball, 1st and 10 at their own 23.5 yards.
Well, that was good coverage up the middle, forced them out wide, and Colgrove one-on-one in open field. He just put the helmet right in the numbers and just made a great tackle out there, nice form tackle, and he went nowhere. So here comes the defense, as we mentioned. If they can hold him here, Gus, we're going to get the ball back in good field position, and we have time before half.
That's the type of tackle you see when they're doing them in practice. Beautiful form tackle. 1st and 10, Mendon, own 23-yard line. Hand off to the right side, and not for much. 1 yard as Brian Cahill and Jim Hardy in on the tackle, as Dennis Jones has seemed to take the place of Eric George. I'm not sure that anyone takes the place of Eric George, but he's in the game replacing him. As to be honest, we do not spot Eric George anywhere on the sideline.
Well, I didn't see him as being injured there on that particular last play he was in there, Don, so.
I have now spotted him on the sideline. He's standing just watching the game for some reason, unknown to us here, quite a ways away from the field. 2nd and 9, pitch goes to Steve Schutz, who gains 2 yards, open field tackle beautifully, by Rich Frazier.
Well, that option was played just perfect. You can't ask any better than that. We had Mitchell coming up on the inside and Getson to shut off the first option up the middle. Toit was wide, had the pitch. The quarterback had to keep it up, go upfield, and there was Rich Frazier who made another great solo one-on-one tackle.
2 minutes, 29 seconds left to go in the first half. A reminder that halftime report is brought to you by Brown & Brown, attorneys at law, St. Ignace and Cedarville, as well as the player of the week selection. Back to pass is Jones. He's looking, is almost intercepted by Brian Cahill. Buzz Griffith, for a minute, appeared to be open, but Brian Cahill made a spectacular defensive play.
He plays that as well as anyone over on the corner, and he timed that perfect. We're seeing it on the replay up here right now, and just as that ball got there, he cut across in front of it, and if he could have got another hand on there, he would have had six. That was just a beautiful play by Brian Cahill, and now it's fourth down. And they're going to have to punt it away. Saints are going to have good field position and just enough time to get one in, another one before half, Don.
The clock stops with 2 minutes 15 seconds and a half following the incompleted pass. The Saints will get the ball back following Chris Miller's punt. The punt is up. It's another line drive type deal to Cahill. I don't know if he touched it or not. We'll see. It was close to being touched. The officials are signaling that apparently it's St. Ignace's ball at the 27-yard line. For a minute up here, it appeared as if Cahill touched the ball.
Well, he had an idea, and it was going by him. He pulled his hand back quickly, and it almost would have been disaster there. But, of course, it's bad enough as it is because he could have picked that ball up on the 35 with running room, but instead we're back on the 27 with under 2 minutes to go in half, so it's going to be tough to get on the board now.
Bo Bradford and Rick Leedy will handle the halftime festivities here until I get back, as I have to make a quick jaunt here as soon as half's over down to the public announcer's booth for the band halftime show. Running with the ball is Steve Becker. Nowhere. Off the Mendon defense is picking up to this occasion. They catch Steve Becker now for a 3 or 4 yard loss. They mark it at the 25, so it'll be a 3 yard loss for Steve Becker.
Well, it was just nowhere for him to go. He did what he could, but the blocking just had broke down there in that particular play. And, of course, every play doesn't run to perfection. If it did, it would just be score all the time. But the defense, they're tough. That's why they're here.
7-6, Saints lead. Back to pass is Frazier. Open is Brian Cahill. He catches it at his 25, gets out to the 27. There was such a deep pass route taken as Rich Frazier faded back that Brian Cahill actually gains only about 1 or 2 yards.
Well, I think they wanted to run a screen over there, a middle screen, but there were too many men and defenders right in the middle of it. So Rich had to roll out of there, and he did. Cahill, being the smart player that he was, he kind of got open, broke to an open area, and was able to get back to the line of scrimmage, or it would have been a big loss back there for Frazier. So good play by Cahill on that breakdown.
Coming up on 30 seconds left in the half, the Saints lead this one 7-6. Third down and 11. Frazier back to pass. He's sacked by number 89, who is not listed in the Mendon program. A big loss on the play, and there's timeout on the field called by Mendon as they're going to get the ball back. A 10-yard loss on the play. The ball now back at the Saints 17-yard line. So fourth down and 21 coming up for the Saints. 14 seconds left in the half. Every motorist can really appreciate a one-stop service facility. On US 2 West is the St. Ignace Truck Stop and Restaurant, open 24 hours a day to serve you with larger, newly remodeled facilities, including barrier-free entries, restrooms, and showers. They have a full line of tires, diesel fuel, and batteries. While your vehicle is being taken care of, you can enjoy home-style meals in the friendly atmosphere of the restaurant. The St. Ignace Truck Stop and Restaurant on US 2 West, open 24 hours a day. This year, don't let the winter blahs get you down. Think about how nice it would be to spend time in a warmer climate or with family or friends in another part of the country. Your winter vacation is so easy to arrange. Simply phone Bayside Travel of Petoskey at 616-347-0020. They will make all your reservations for you at no extra cost and mail your tickets to you. Contact Bayside Travel of Petoskey and let them arrange your vacation. Phone 616-347-0020. Coming down to the end of the half, we want to remind you this game is brought to you in part by the First National Bank, who has put forth a substantial sum to help out this broadcast and the replay on Monday night. So the Saints forced with a 4th and 21, and I don't know how we'll find out But it seems odd that Eric George isn't in the lineup for Mendon.
Well, it does seem strange. No, he must have, all I can think, Don, is that he strained something on that kickoff return at the last we saw of him. And I don't know exactly what's happening, but here we go. We got to have a punt. No breakdowns. That's what we're hoping for.
Steve Becker standing in his own five. The punt is up. It's straight up in the air. It will land at the 45 and bounce to the 50, and it keeps bouncing into Mendon territory. They'll take over at the 47-yard line with 3 seconds left, so they'll have one play.
Well, that was a fine job. Let's get that off. Of course, Mendon was going for the block. They had quite a bit of pressure on them there, but Coach Pearson had his gang over there on the side, and he was setting up just what he wanted so that they couldn't block it, and it worked all right just fine. And Becker got off a good high kick there out across midfield there. Mendon will have time for one play here, Gus, but it's going to be a Hail Mary, or either that, or they're just going to let the clock run out here and go in at halftime down by one.
32-yard punt, no return. Mendon takes over first and 10 at their own 47. Dodge Marksman 1000, the special edition hunter's truck that comes with a Winchester, is a tribute to the great outdoors and those who love it. Dodge has created the Marksman 1000. The Ram Tough D150 or W150, 4x2 or 4x4, with special paint, stripes, and special wheels and tires. Plus, you get a limited edition Winchester 30-30 rifle tailor-made for the serious hunter. There's only going to be 30 of these trucks and rifles available in the northern part of the state. So stop by O'Connor, Chrysler, Plymouth, Dodge, and Pickford and order yours today. As we see Wayne LaGrieve and the St. Ignace Saint marching band getting ready to take the field, Rick.
Well, they're all marching out here in force, and they look sharp, and they're black and white and gold, and we had the Flag Corps girls there, too, ready to go with them, and so things are setting up for a halftime performance here.
So we're ready for the what should be the final play of the half, barring a penalty. Jones ready to take the snap from center, hands off up the middle, and the half is over as a gain of 4 yards on the play is all for Chris Haas. 7-6, Saints lead at halftime.
George's Body Shop on North State Street in downtown St. Ignace. The State Bar and Grill, where they have the finest hamburgers. State Representative Pat Gagliardi, if you need help with state government, let Pat know. Brown and Brown, attorneys at law, St. Ignace and Cedarville. Mackinac Sales, Ford and Mercury dealers, it's service after the sale that counts. UP Snack Food, St. Ignace, the Eastern Upper Peninsula distributor for Tom's products. Dwight's Auto Clinic, specialists in welding, they repair from the engine to the tailpipe. The St. Ignace Truck Stop and Restaurant, your one-stop service facility on West US 2. Statewide Real Estate of St. Ignace, George Shinsky Realtor. Superior Floor Covering of St. Ignace, check out their sale. St. Ignace Electric, serving the Eastern Upper Peninsula and Mackinac Island. McGregor Oil, Shell Dealers, say yes to Michigan. TNT Electronics, your area RCA television dealer. Winkleman's, your headquarters for name brand apparel and footwear, downtown St. Ignace. First National Bank, your 5 o'clock bank, member FDIC.
say hello back in St. Ignace to my summertime employers, Maureen and John Littnitz at the Gamble store, where I sort of do a little part-time help during the summertime. They couldn't make it down to the game, but I promised I'd say hello. The second half is underway. The kick goes to Becker on the 20, to the 25, to the 30. He is down at the 33-yard line. That's where the Saints will start off. First and 10 at their own 33, following a 40-yard kick and a 13-yard return.
Well, there's no excuses now. Both teams have had a half under their belt to get things ironed out. They've had adjustments at halftime by the coaches, and now it's just going to be right hard-nosed football, no mistakes. And let's see whether the St. offense can get back on the board. We're making Bo nervous over here, just having a one-point lead.
There have been no turnovers in this game, and a turnover could be critical to either team if that occurs. St. Ignace, handoff up the middle, no yardage at all. On the run, Brian Cahill. And they move the ball about a foot. And it'll remain second and 10, no huddle. The Saints ready to go again. Hand off this time, Oya. He's got some room to the 41-yard line. They caught Mendon sleeping a little and gained 8 yards on the play, and it'll be third and 2.
Seems to be big holes off tackle down as it was earlier, and we're going again without a huddle. So Coach Pearson, a little trickery in the locker room at halftime.
Give them 9, third and 1. Hand off, reverse. Becker coming this way. 45, down 48-yard line, but it's a first down. First time we've seen the reverse. It's good this time for 7 yards and a first down for the Saints.
And boy, there was a big hole there, but he ran into Cahill, who was blocking for him downfield. If he could have just cut to the outside instead of in, of course, we have a nice angle up here as we're looking down there, and Becker would have been off to the races, but he wasn't. But a first down, and the Saints are moving it.
First and 10 ball at the St. 48-yard line. Saints lead 7-6. Back to pass is Rich Frazier. Open over the middle, Jerry Caldwell complete. First down to the 40-yard line. A gain of 12 yards on the play.
It's a nice pass pattern, and we had a man open on the flats over there, and that was Becker. So first down and going to the pass. So we thought that Coach Pearson might go to the air just a little bit more here in the second half on second down as well as third, but here on first down, he starts out with a pass.
Trying to give Mendon a little bit less time to get prepared. As 62 defense, off they go, reverse coming this way. Becker to the 35, 7 yard gain to the 33-yard line. The reverse opens up for 7 yards.
Another nice big hole coming back to this side, and the offense has things going now, and the old momentum is starting to pick up with the State offense, and they're moving it well.
Second down and 3, and the Saints hurriedly moving the ball down the field as Mendon has very little time to get set up as they want to. Now in a 63 defense, it appears. Matt Oya running left to the 30-yard line, to the 25. He goes out of bounds at the 22-yard line, but it's a first down. And a gain of 11 yards on the play and another Saint first down.
Well, it's just offensive line now, Don. They're doing the job because no matter what we've done here so far in the second half, it's working. The traps are open. Now we're going outside. We've got off tackle, and every play has been for a big gainer. And now another first down. We're just outside the 20, so it's looking good here now.
It's amazing how Barry Pearson gets them fired up during the halftime locker room talk. First and 10, ball at the Mendon 23. Handoff goes to Cahill up the middle. He doesn't get much. There's not much up the middle. You have a whole stack of Mendon tacklers in there, 1 yard for Cahill.
Well, that's the only play that Mendon's been able to shut down so far in the second half. Down, we've run it twice, and we've only got 1 yard both times.
Second down and 9. Coming up, 9 minutes, 27 seconds left to go in the third quarter. Saints lead 7-6. The ball sits at the Mendon 22-yard line. In motion, Becker. Handoff to Becker. Roll coming right. Got some trouble in front of him, but he manages to get to the 20, which is a gain of 2 yards on the play, and it'll be third and about 7.
Well, 2 yards doesn't sound like much, but he made some really nice cuts right there. He could have been held for no gain and even a loss, and he used his blocker just extremely well, course, we've talked about his quickness before, and he just cut outside back in, threw the defenders off a little bit, and he could dive forward for two.
Erskine and Shinsky come into the game. Cahill and Brown go out. Third and seven for the Saints from the Mendon 20. Hand off Oya to the 15-yard line. It'll be about fourth and two and a half.
Well, we're in four down territory. We'll be going for it. We're not going to risk any field goal, I'm sure, here, Don, and that attempt, that is. We're going to go for the first down and try to get on the board early.
Fourth and about three. If you get to the 12-yard line, it is a first down as the stick ends just short of the 12. Brown in for Shinsky.
That tells me pass.
Fourth and three. We'll see. Mendon crowd trying to get fired up. The Saints likewise. Fourth and three. Back to pass is Frazier. Under heavy pursuit. He throws it up for grabs. It's incomplete. He was under heavy pressure by number 57 of Mendon, who is Joe Millard, right in on the tackle. He was in. He forced Frazier to throw a pass. The pattern that time didn't really open up.
Well, it didn't. They came, everybody started to the left, and Frazier was on a little bootleg back to the right. He's trying to hit Andy Brown in that little flat that's been effective for him all year, but the defensive Mendon didn't roll that way that they thought they were. They stayed right here in the zone, and as Andy went out, he went right into two defenders there, and there was nowhere to go.
Mendon takes over the ball, first and 10 at their own 15-yard line. Penalty flags on the play. It appears to be on Mendon. It's easy to work up a good appetite over any exciting sporting event. That's why Elias Brothers Big Boy Restaurant on West US 2 in St. Ignace is open 24 hours a day, 7 days a week. You can stop by any time after any game and enjoy delicious snacks, full meal, or just a dessert. Take care of your appetite after this game by stopping by the Elias Brothers Big Boy Restaurant on West US 2 in St. Ignace. So a 5-yard illegal procedure penalty on Mendon. That's their fifth penalty of the day for 35 yards. The Saints still have no penalties. They actually had one. It was declined. It doesn't count against you. So it's first and 15 as Mendon backed up to their own 10-yard line.
Big time for the defense.
First and 15. Handoff up the middle. A gain of 7 yards on the play as the Hornets are able to get out to the 17, and that is Eric George. The first time we've seen him in a long time. He gets 7 yards on the play. That's only his second. That was 32, I correct myself, not 34. Rick Clark on the run thought it was 34. Eric George, who is still not in the game. Rick Clark gets 7 yards on the play, and it'll be second down and eight. The ball at the 17-yard line. Handoff and big running room for Steve Schultz. He's off to the races. 45-50, 45-40, 30-yard line, and brought down by Matt Oya at the 24-yard line. So the gain on the play, good for 68 yards.
Well, it was only Oya's speed that kept him out of the end zone right there. They just ran off tackle on the right-hand side. Glenn Gibson just missed him. Cahill was out there being blocked, turned the back of the inside a little bit. Oya was coming across in the middle and was able to just outrun the man there and put him out of bounds just before he could turn the corner and get a TD. So now the defense has really got their back against the wall. They've got to come through now.
First and 10, ball at the St. Ignace 24-yard line. Going up the middle for big yardage is Rick Clark. He gets all the way to the 11-yard line, a gain of 13 yards. And Mendon is knocking on the door. The ball placed at the same 11-yard line.
Oh, that's a turnaround. The defense had him way down at the other end. Only two plays ago, Don, and now they got their back to their own goal down at this end. And that's the defense has just got to pick it up. They're there. A few hand tackles, a couple of missed tackles, and they're right down in there. So first down, they've got to stop him on the first down play.
First and 10, ball on the St. 12. Handoff goes to Steve Schutz. He gets to about the 10, a gain of 2 yards on the play. Steve Schutz with that big run a few minutes ago now is 108 yards on 8 carries.
Well, that's a big play right there because that makes second long, and you can't give them those big yards on first down because then they have second, third, and even fourth now to get the first down. So that's a big play by Hardy. Tripped him up for his short gainer, so now it's second and long. And now here's a real big one too, Don. They have to hold him to small yardage on this second down because they have four to get it here.
Second and eight, ball at the Saints 10-yard line. Snap from center, handoff, not much there. Rick Clark, it appears, gets to the 9. That'll be a 1-yard gain, and I think it's 3rd and 7.
Big play right there, and here's where the defense, 2 more plays, and they have to shine here. They have to keep them out of the end zone, Don.
That was Rick Clark as he unpiles from the line of scrimmage. 3rd and about 6, maybe 7. The ball is inside the 9. We'll call it 7. Well, you have to get inside the 2 for a first down.
They're going to go wide now, Don. You've got to look out for the pitch to the quarterback going wide or the little pass in the flat.
3rd and 7. Jones on the opposite pitches. The feet shoot, end zone touchdown shoot. The Mendon crowd goes wild. Steve shoots on the 8-yard touchdown run. Puts Mendon back in the lead with 5:19 left to go in the third quarter. Mendon takes the lead.
Perfect execution. Quarterback came around. He held the ball long enough to the end, picked him up, pitched the ball just right, and Erskine got outrun to the corner. And Brad, of course, is playing back there. He had to stay back with the man in the end zone. He had to look out for pass. And of course, he got caught in the middle. Couldn't come up like he wanted to, and he got beat to the corner.
Mendon going for 2 as expected as they lead here 12-7. Hand off to number 21. He is not in the end zone. He is stopped short. Dennis Jones does not make it in the end zone.
Big play by Caveman Lee right there. He cut back behind him. Lee was really moving to the ball with the flow, and he cut back behind him, but he's able to get his arm out there and trip him up. He fell just before the line, so that could turn out to be a very big play.
Hornets 12, Saints 7, 5:19 left to go in the third quarter. There's more to a service station than just putting gas in your tank, and they'll prove it at Selden's Marathon Service in St. Ignace. They'll check your tires and oil, clean your windows, check your battery, and fill your tank with fine Marathon gasoline and diesel fuel. They'll even wash your vehicle. In these self-serve days, your Marathon station tries harder to please. Drive into Selden's Marathon Service, North State Street, St. Ignace. They're open 7 days a week with 3 certified mechanics. And some outdoor projects are just too big to handle on your own. That's when you call Art Husky & Sons Excavating of St. Ignace. In addition to quality excavating work, Art Husky & Sons handle landscaping and snow removal and have sand, gravel, and topsoil to complete your landscaping project. When there's a big job to be done around your place, call Art Husky & Sons Excavating of St. Ignace. Just been handed the official attendance. Today's Class D game has an attendance of 11,528.
That's a pretty good crowd here, Don, and they're really vocal. The Mendon crowd over here is all excited after that score. And now the Saints side, we got to get them something to holler about over there now, too.
You can imagine what this dome stadium must be like when they fill it up and have 80,000 screaming people in here.
I can't even imagine, because the second and third decks here aren't even touched. There's not a person in them, so it must be something when they get them all in here.
5:19 left in the third quarter. The kick is off. It goes to Steve Becker on his own 13, to the 15, to the 20, to the 25, to the 30, and down at the 32-yard line. So the Saints take over first and 10 at their own 32, following the 47-yard kickoff and the 19-yard return.
Well, we've got to generate that offense. We've got to get it going again. We got right down in there last time and couldn't make it on third and fourth down in about 5 or 6. So we've got to get back down in there. And that particular kickoff right there, Don, Becker was close to breaking it. He got slowed up there, and there was a hole up the middle, but that was close.
He was tackled by his shirt. If he would have not been able to be held onto, he would have gone. Becker threw a hole, gets about 5 yards. The ball is going to be spotted at the 38-yard line. They'll give him 6 yards on the play. It'll be 2nd and 4.
That's a good play. If you can get 6 yards on first down, that really makes it easier for you, easier for the offense on second and third down. We've got to just have a nice sustained drive here. We've got to move it down in there, Don.
2nd and 4. Hand off Steve Becker. He gets to the 43-yard line. He should have the first down if they spot it where it appears to be.
It is a first down.
It is a first down, I think. That's what the officials say. So a 4-yard gain for Steve Becker and a first down. The ball out to the St. Ignace 43-yard line. And it's 1st and 10.
Well, we caught the Mendon defense shifting a little bit right there, and they weren't quite set. And, of course, where the man was moving on the left-hand side of their defense, and we happened to run right up that hole. So good yardage and a first down.
First and 10. Ball on the St. 42. Rich Frazier rolls left. He's tripped up behind the line of scrimmage for a one-yard loss. It'll be second and 11.
Well, we got to get something going here, Gus. Wouldn't be surprised we see a double reverse worked last time twice in the last series. We might go to something like that. We might go to a little pass maybe even right here with second and long. We've got to hit on some sort of a big play and get this offense fired up and moving again.
Second down and 11. Handoff, Steve Becker, he's got a big hole for a second and finally picked up nicely by Mendon. He gets out to the 46, a gain of 5. It'll be third and 6.
Well, that was a nice play, and he almost broke that one again. So, again, the offense is getting close, ever so close, to breaking that big run. They just can't quite seem to get past that one last defender there. If we ever could, we'd be all right.
Third down and 6. Ball on the Saints, 46. A big third down play upcoming for the Saints. Back to pass is Frazier. He's sacked at the 35-yard line. A loss of 11 yards on the play. It'll be fourth and 17 as Frazier was not given enough time to set up and get his patterns going.
The offensive line on this series is not doing a job. We said they were doing a great job in the last series, and this time they haven't. Now, whether the defense is just that much more pumped up after that score, sometimes that happens, but whatever. We got to turn it back over, and the D's going to have another shot.
Becker back to punt. The kick is up. It's a good
nice
one.
Punt.
Fair catch called by number 4, Buzz Griffith, at his own 25-yard line. So the punt, good for 40 yards and no return. And Mendon starts off first and 10 at their own 25.
That's an excellent punt.
Visitors to Michigan's Upper Peninsula will be more than pleased with the comfortable accommodations at the Huron Motel across from the State Police Post on North State Street in St. Ignace. The Huron Motel is open year-round with 15 units. They feature hot water heat, tubs with showers and water beds. And right now you'll save with off-season rates. Enjoy your stay in our area. Stop by the Huron Motel across from the State Police Post in St. Ignace. So Mendon starts off in relatively poor field position again, first and 10 on their own 25. Last time they started on the 10.
Well, the defense has got to do the job, and they can't give up the big play.
Back to pass, it appears, is Jones, and he's sacked by Caveman Lee. Caveman Lee finally gets to the quarterback. We need a good rush out of him, and that's finally what we get. He's taking the defensive ball into his own hands, as Hardy did earlier in the game. 8-yard loss on the play, and the ball goes back to the 17-yard line.
Well, a great rush there by Scott Mitchell to get that whole thing set up. He put the pressure on, made the quarterback roll out of the pocket, and Caveman Lee, or Chet, his blocker, was right there to pick up what was left. And a nice loss, second long now. They got to hold him down in the hole.
They forced them to punt. The Saints would end up with good field position. Hand off. Nothing on the play at all. Number 2, Steve Shute, actually loses a yard. It's back at the 16-yard line now, and it'll be third down and 19 for the Hornets.
Great play by Scott Mitchell. Took on his blocker and worked him right to the outside, right into Hardy, who was there waiting to turn it in. Between the two of them, another yard loss. So here's a big play. Third and long. They've got to hold him back in there, Gus. Forced the punt, which would give us excellent field position when we got it back.
A big play. Third down and 19. 1 minute left to go in the third quarter. Hornets 12, St. 7. Still with the ball is Jones. He pitches the ball to Steve Shute. He gets to the 25-yard line, a gain of 9, but that's not enough for the first down. It is fourth down and 10, and Mendon forced into a punting situation.
Well, that's what we were hoping for, and the offense is going to get the ball right back. 3 plays and punt. Good job by the defense right there. And just as we saw a while ago, the defense pumping up the offense. Maybe it's going to happen for the Saints right here now as we're going to get the ball back here.
Last time, a poor snap from center almost ended in a Saint block punt. We see another poor snap. The Saints might be right in on top of it.
Well, it could be.
Chris Miller is back to punt, standing at his own 13. A good snap from center. He gets a nice kick off. It goes over everyone's head. Rich Frazier picks it up at his own 20, to the 25, to the 30, and he's brought down there, and a late hit on the play by number four, Buzz Griffith, will add on 15 yards, and that was a good call.
Yes, there was. There was no doubt about it. The Mendon crowd here is booing, but that was very obvious. And that's at the 27. That should be a 15 more, which puts them up over the 40. And you can't start in any better field position than that, Don.
Although we must give Chris Miller some credit. He banged a punt that was good for 55 yards.
Well, he surprised the people that we had back, and he put it right over their head. And Fraser was on the run back to cut it off, and he still couldn't get it. So that was a great punt, as you said.
55-yard punt, 7-yard return, 15-yard penalty tacked on. The Saints take over the ball, first and 10, at their own 42-yard line. And that is the end of the third quarter. With the score, Mendon 12, St. Ignace 7, will be back for fourth quarter action after telling you that if you're ready for a good meal out, visit the Driftwood Restaurant and Lounge in St. Ignace. The Driftwood Restaurant features affordable family dining at its best from 7 a.m. to 10 p.m. Their menu includes delicious daily luncheon and dinner specials, as well as the best pizza in town. And of course, takeout orders are available. That's the Driftwood Restaurant and Lounge, 590 North State Street, St. Ignace, across from the Starline Boat. And McGregor Oil Company of St. Ignace is your local distributor for quality Shell gas and oil products. Take advantage of the convenience of their self-serve station on US 2 at the I-75 interchange, or for complete service, stop by their Shell service station at the corner of McCann and State Streets in downtown St. Ignace. McGregor Oil, serving your area with dependable Shell gas and oil products. So the Saints will take over first and 10 on their own 42, down 12-7 as the fourth quarter starts.
Here we go. We have one quarter to go in this big old beautiful Silverdome, Gus, and those kids got to be suck it up now. We've got to put a drive together, get it down in there. Here's the time you can't afford penalties, any kind of a turnover. We've got to get some yards, get it down in there, and even if we have to punt or turn the ball over, it's got to be in poor field position for Mendon so we can get it back again or whatever. But this is getting critical now.
Two fine teams, two well-coached teams. Meeting here in the Silverdome for the first time ever, the Saints and Mendon reverse the Becker, and it's gobbled up behind the line of scrimmage for a 1-yard loss.
Way too much penetration. Our offensive line is not doing the job right now. They had some trouble in the last series. They have trouble again right here. There was a double reverse, and there was two men deeper than the man getting the ball. So the offensive line, they just have to hold those blocks longer if we're going to move the ball.
Second down and 11. The ball is on the Saint 41. We need a big play. There's no doubt about it. Back to pass is Frazier. Open is Colgrove, who makes the catch. He's close to a first down. Let's see where the official spotted at the Mendon 48-yard line. It might take a measurement on this one. It is extremely close. First down, Saints.
First down by the nose of the ball. Colgrove, nice play by Colgrove. He knew where that first down marker was, and he sure didn't get it by any too much, but he got it, and that's all that counts. And now we're inside the 50. First down for the Saints.
My stomach is having butterflies galore right now. First and 10. The ball is on the Mendon 48. Frazier up the middle for 3 yards to the 45, so it'll be second and 7.
Well, 3 yards isn't bad. Of course, anytime you get to 3, you're hoping to break it. Got to catch that defense off balance. They're blitzing more now, and if you catch them when those linebackers are coming and get by them, it's going to be off to the races. So it's a guessing game now, but it's second down.
Second down and 7. The ball is on the Mendon 45-yard line. The Saints are on the drive. In motion is Becker. There's a penalty flag on the play. Becker gets good yardage, 12, 13 yards on the play, but the Saints had illegal motion or illegal procedure.
Well, we had our left tackle a little bit too excited. He jumped in there. It would have been a nice run, too, but it's nullified, and that's one of the first times today that the Saints have had a penalty that hurt their drive.
The first time they have been nailed for penalty yardage, the other time they had a penalty, it was nullified. Are you having a little trouble with your car or truck? Maybe you've been involved in a bit of a fender bender. Don't be too concerned. Help is as near as George's Body Shop in St. Ignace. They have 24-hour wrecker service, new and used parts, a master mechanic on duty, and a reputable bumping and painting department. When you have trouble with your vehicles, let the experts at George's Body Shop in St. Ignace take your worries away. Second down, 12. Shotgun formation. Frazier back deep to pass. He's back to the 30, now the 35, and he gets nailed at the 40-yard line for a 10-yard loss.
Well, that was a devastating play right there. We lost, looks like about 10, 11 yards there, Don. And now we're going to have third and long, long yardage.
Third and 22, they mark it.
And that's almost impossible to pick up something like that. But, it's going to be the defense back on the field here again. If we can't get something going, I don't know what you'd run here, a screen. Maybe the dipsy doodle. We haven't seen that old dipsy doodle yet today.
Third and 22. The Saints have actually moved back 2 yards from where they originally started the drive off. Back in the shotgun formation is Frazier. Brown's open. He falls down. He has some open yardage, only 5 yards on the play, though. It'll be fourth and 17.
Well, he was underthrown. He was wide open over on the flats. Of course, he was one-on-one over there with the cornerback, so if he could have picked that up in stride, it would have been interesting to see what's going to happen. But Frazier underthrew him a little bit. He had to dive down to catch the ball. So now we got to punt it out of there on fourth.
Under 10 minutes left to go in the Silverdome. Saints 7, Hornets 12. Steve Becker back to punt. The punt is up, and it's a pretty good one. It's caught by Buzz Griffiths and dropped and recovered at his own 18-yard line. So the punt was good for 42 yards and no return. Mendon starts off first and 10 on the 18th. The Saint defense has to hold them again and hope the offense can come through. Of course, we haven't seen any turnovers. It would be an opportune time for the defense to force a turnover.
Well, this is it. We're getting down there. We're down inside 9.5 minutes. The defense has to make some big plays. They can't afford a time-consuming ground game to chew it up. They've got to stop them, and they've got to force a turnover here right away.
First and 10, ball at the Mendon 18. Handoff and big yardage for Steve Stoops. He may go all the way. 50, 40, 30, 20. 10-yard line and brought out of bounds and appears to be the 8-yard line. A gain on the play of 73 yards.
That's a crushing blow to the defense. Of course, they haven't scored yet, and they're down to the 10, so there's no more first downs. They can't get another first down without scoring. So defensive-wise, that's a pretty good, if you can see any light out of this at all, they've got to score from 9 yards out now. There's no more first downs for them, and that's a plus for the defense. But, of course, that was a devastating blow on a run like that. Most of the defense ran right by the man and didn't even see he had the ball. Here we go.
First and goal to goal, ball at the 9-yard line. Illegal procedure on the play by Mendon will move them back first and goal to goal of the 14. Good to know you can rely on Dave's Red Owl in downtown St. Ignace for terrific grocery savings week after week. Right now they have 3-pound cans of Maxwell House coffee at $1.50 off with a coupon, fresh ground hamburger for just 99 cents a pound, and a pound and a half loaves of Red Owl white bread at 2 for 89 cents. Shop and save at Dave's Red Owl on State Street in downtown St. Ignace, open daily 9 to 9, Sunday 10 to 5. I promise I'd say hello to Rich Corwin, who's manning the shop back there at Dave's Red Owl today. We hope you're listening. The Saints in trouble here. The Hornets lead 12 to 7, and the Hornets have the ball first and goal at the Saints 14-yard line. Handoff, faked handoff, and now it's stepped out of bounds, I believe. The official did not feel he stepped out of bounds. Rick Clark gets up to the 7. From this viewpoint, it looked like he might have stepped out of bounds up about the 12.
Well, it was awfully close down there, but apparently he didn't. He just got close. The defense has second down now and 7 facing him. And we're looking at the replay.
I think he was out of bounds. And there was 1 foot touch the line.
It was awfully close at any rate, but they didn't get it. So now here's the defense back against the wall. Second down and 7.
Second and goal to goal from the 7. 8:59 left in the game. Hornets 12, Saints 7. Oh, there's a penalty flag thrown. The whistles blow. Whistles blow. It's an offsides or an illegal procedure call. We'll see who it's on. Somebody either lined up offsides or moved. Illegal procedure, Mendon.
Oh.
So another penalty on Mendon. 60 yards now in penalties. Makes it second and goal to goal from the 12.
Big break. That's all the defense can hope is a few breakdown by Mendon right there. And that's going to put him second in goal to goal from the 12 now. And that is a big difference than going from the 7. You're It's going to be tough to get in with three running plays, hopefully, from there, Don.
Sure is. Second and goal to goal from the 12. The Saints are against a mean foe.
Well, the Saints have had some great goal line stands through the year. Let's hope they can get another one.
Hand off to number 47, who is Chris Haas. He gets to the 6. A gain of 5 yards on the play makes it third and goal to goal from the 6. Two plays they have to get 6 yards, Mendon. The Saints hopefully can have to hold them in two plays.
Well, if Coach Pearson and Coach Sweener can ever outguess the Mendon offense, this is the time to do it. This is one big play right here. Third down and goal from the 6. And if they can hold them here and force them fourth and long, that would be an awful break for the defense. So let's see what happens.
A big play. Third and goal to goal from the 6. Still with the ball is Jones. He's tackled at the 7. A loss of a yard on the play makes it fourth and goal to goal from the 7, and it appeared to be Mitchell.
Big Scott Mitchell, and a big play by him in there. I shouldn't say big Scott Mitchell. He's playing big, but he's pretty small in there in that defensive line, but that was, we said, a big play right there. And now they have fourth and goal from the 7. Good position for the defense.
Mendon wants timeout. They want to talk it over. I don't know how Mendon's place kicker is. They possibly might think about a field goal here. That would put the score at 15-7 if they would make a field goal and put the Saints down by 8 points, forcing them to score and then make the two-point conversion, or of course go for the touchdown. If you score, you go up by 2 touchdowns. If you don't score, the Saints still with 1 touchdown win the game.
Well, by looking at the scores that Mendon has been putting on the boards during the year, I think they generally probably go for it in this situation. They don't run up the scores they've been running by kicking too many field goals, but we'll have to just wait and see, of course, here what happens. And the defense is huddling out there. We need one big play out of somebody coming up right away.
My heart is going at about 100 miles an hour right now. Their place kicker, I have it written down in one of the programs, is 44, I believe. Joe Hawes.
He's changing his shoe right now out there.
They're going to try for 3 and force, if they make the field goal, they will force the Saints then to score and make the two-point conversion. Of course, remember the kick earlier today was missed and the extra point attempt.
That's right, and of course this could be the big old fake out too of going with something else to try to get that touchdown. So we'll just have to wait and see what unfolds here. Things are getting tense at the Silver Dome.
I don't even know if that's the word for it. It's something else there.
It's at an angle. They're off to the right.
Chris Miller. They're faking it, as we guessed.
And he saves.
The Saints have the ball at the 10-yard line. Paul gets it. Scott Mitchell finishes him off. Paul Getson was the man who made the initial hit. Then came in Lee, and Scott Mitchell finished him off. It was Paul Getson who made the initial hit.
It was big Paul Getson. We had to have a big play, and there's a big play from a big man right there, and the defense comes up with 2 in a row.
First and 10, Saints ball at their own 10.
Come on offense.
7:37 left in the game. Hand off Cahill. He's got 10 yards and an upending tackle. He's close to a first down, extremely close. It depends on where the officials mark it.
It's a first down.
Touchdown Saints to the 20-yard line, and we have to have a drive at this point in the game.
Here we go. That started off right there with Cahill with that tremendous effort. He dove for the first down. Here's what we need.
The Saints crowd is on their feet. It's first and 10 for the Saints from their own 20. And still with the ball is Frazier. He keeps it, gains 5 yards on the play. They mark him down at about the 25-yard line. Give Frazier 5 yards. It'll be second and 5 with 7:08 left to go in the game.
Well, that seems like an eternity when you're on defense, and when you're on offense and have to score. It looks like a long time, too, but that time runs off fast when you're a ground-type team, and we're going to have to do something with it right away.
Hand off. Matt Oya, correction, 4 yards on the play. It'll be third down and 1.
Good position for a first down. We can pick it up right here. We've got to get that first down, keep things going, 5 yards, 4 yards. So the offensive line is starting to pick it up. They're starting to do the job. We're getting some good hard running out of our backs. Go Saints.
It's third down and a long one. The Saints, I think, have to snap the ball quicker as Mendon taking a long time to get set on defense. Hand off Cahill, first down and more. Ooh. To the 36-yard line, a gain of 8 yards on the play, and another Saints first down. Brian Cahill with a big run when necessary. The ball now first and 10 at the Saint 36.
Well, he was hit at the line, but he's not going to be denied. A senior in the Silverdome, and he wants it bad, and he showed it right there. He got an extra 5 on his own.
6 minutes, 10 seconds. Hornets 12, Saint 7 from Pontiac. Hand off. Brad Erskine to the 45, 50. Oh. He's tackled in an upending tackle, but a nice gain on the play of 16 yards and a first down for the Saints as they move into Mendon territory at the 49.
Oh, big hole off the right-hand side, and the offensive line is doing the job right now. Big hole for Erskine as he crosses midfield, and we have a timeout now. Mendon, they're trying to regroup, Don.
Defensively, they have a way falling apart here. The Saints were able to go. That was a funny play there, as in it appeared that the center was the first man up and the rest of the line took a second before they reacted to the snap from center.
Well, they don't want any penalties, and they're just holding off to make sure that ball is snapped first. I'm sure Coach Pearson is out there saying, don't be offside. The penalty now would really put the pressure on the offense in this drive right here. And this could seal it as we're under 6 minutes. So we've got to have a continue this drive here, Gus. This is a big one.
You're listening to WMKC FM 103 and Great Community Television. I'm Don Gustafson along with Rick Leedy, Bo Bradford. Gary Rickley is with us. And I'll tell you, I want to thank Rick Stone and Jerry Gallagher and Martin Brennan, wherever he may be in the land down under, for giving us this opportunity to do this all football season. It's surely been a memorable experience and one I won't forget.
Well, that's certainly true, Gus, and this is great. Boy, this is excitement, and you know, you get out of coaching, out of football, and you kind of get away from all this Pollard and all that sort of thing, but boy, it's back now, and there's goose pimples on Gus's arms, and things are getting tight.
5 minutes, 58 seconds. It's now or never time. It's coming down to that point. Ball at the Mendon 49. Back to pass is Frazier. He throws complete to Erskine to the 43-yard line. A gain of 6. It'll be 2nd and 4.
Nice play right there by Frazier under heavy pressure. Rolling here to the left. He hit Erskine. He underthrew him. Erskine came back, made a nice catch right there. And there's a big 6 to 7 yards on that play right there. And that means a lot in a drive because now they've got two more plays or we're getting into 4 down territory, 3 even, to pick up the 3 yards.
2nd and 4, ball at the Mendon, 43-yard line. Hand off Steve Becker. He's tackled behind the line of scrimmage for a 1 yard loss. It'll be 3rd and 5 at the Mendon 44.
And that's why those first down plays are ever so important, because now we've got 2 downs to make that 4 yards, which is still a good position to be on offense. The pressure's on the Mendon defense, there's no doubt about it. But, of course, we have to score, so we have to keep doing it. Put it down in there.
A fantastic game today from the Pontiac Silverdome. 3rd and 5. Hand off Erskine. He's to the 41. It'll be 4th and about a yard and a half.
Nice spin by Erskine. He couldn't quite get the yard he needed, but he got an extra yard with that spin, and now that pressure's on the offense. 4th and 1. We have to have it right here. We're down to 4 minutes and 36 seconds and counting.
4th down and 1. The biggest play of the game up to this point. The ball at the Mendon 41. Both crowds on their feet. Hand off. Oya. First down safe. 2 yards. And Oya may get the first down for the Saints and keeps this drive going.
Beautiful effort by Matt Oya right there. A little counterplay coming back against the flow. There was quite a bit of penetration. He was hit. He spun on top of the pile and dove over the pile, picked up the first down, and the offense still has it going. We're inside the 40.
The ball at the Mendon 38, 1st and 10. Still with the ball, Frazier. He's running right to the 31-yard line. A gain of 7 on the play. It'll be 2nd and 3 from the Mendon 31.
Great, great play right there. Nice cut back by Frazier. Cross grain back to the middle. Dole forward. Got 7 or 8 yards in there. And again, the first down has been the key play right now in this drive.
Second and three. The ball at the Mendon 31-yard line. Hand off to Oya, it appears. And he has a first down at the 28-yard line of Mendon. 3 yards and a first down. For Matt Oya.
Oh, they're chewing him up right now. The St. offense is clicking. There's another first down in two plays. And this first down is awful important right now, Gus. We're into four down territory.
The ball on the Mendon, 28. The crowd of Mendon a little silent. The crowd of St. Ignace filled with anticipation. Mendon 12, St. 7. Back to pass, Rich Frazier. A heavy rush. He's looking and open. Oh, my God! Oh!
I don't know if anyone heard what just happened right there, but Frazier rolled to the right. There was Shinsky standing right at the corner of the end zone. Frazier hit him just as Shinsky was tackled. He falls in the end zone. Touchdown for St. Ignace. The Saints are ahead 13-12 with 3 minutes and 16 seconds left. The Saints are on top.
28-yard pass from Rich Frazier to Chris Shinsky. The Saints going for two. And off Erskine. In. Good. 2 points. Saints 15. Hornets 12. That was close.
Erskine with a tremendous effort right there. He was hit on about the 2-yard line. He shouldn't have made it in. It was the extra effort and a tremendous ovation from the Saints fans on the other side. They're cheerleading like crazy up here in the press box. Oh, the crowd is going wild. There's only 3 minutes and 16 seconds left, and the Saints are on top, 15-12.
My word, of course, there's still 3 minutes and 16 seconds left. The Saints lead. One thing that is in the Saints' favor, Mendon has used 2 of their timeouts on defense and only has 1 left.
Hey, them boys from the north come down here and play football, didn't they?
They sure did both. Mendon with 1 timeout left. And the Saint marching band is playing when the Saints go marching in.
Well, here we go now. The big defense, the offense, made their play. They made the bid for the win here in the Class D championship game in the Silver Dome. It's going to be on the shoulders of the Saint defense here.
They've been top all season long.
Well, they have, and they've let up a big run in the last 2 series, and they can't afford the big play now that the Coach Pearson coaches against. Don't give them the big play on their offense. So defense, it's going to be up to you.
The reason, of course, the Saints went for 2 is that now a field goal will not beat the Saints. It would tie the Saints. The Saints lead by 3 or 15-12. We're on our way. The kick goes to Rick Clark. So he is stopped at the 31-yard line, it appears. The Mendon will take over the ball with 3 minutes, 10 seconds left at their own 31-yard line.
Oh, and talk about a photo finish. They talk about that in horse racing, and this is going to be a photo finish here in the Silver Dome. Saints got to hang on for the Class D state championship.
First down is a key play, as it was for the Saints, it is for Mendon. If they get big yardage, that opens up their offense. If they don't, they might be forced into the passing game that they are not used to playing.
That's the key right now, the first down play.
First and 10, the snap from center. The pitch goes to 32, Rick Clark, and he doesn't get a lot. 3 yards, it appears. It'll be second and 7. The clock now down to 2:35 left in the game.
And you'll be able to tell what's happening by the roar of the crowd, because when the Saints defense holds him, you can hear the burst from the far sideline. And when the Mendon, if they ever make a first down here, you're going to hear it right underneath our booth. So the crowd will tell you what's happening.
Second and 7, Mendon. Ball at their own 34-yard line. Shotgun formation. Running the ball, Jones, he's still got a chance to pass. It could be intercepted. Might be injured. He
ground. I think he's injured on the play. Who else could make the play but Brian Cahill? What a gallant try to make the interception going down, injured as all from last week, makes a brilliant interception. He had the early touchdown run to put the Saints in the lead the first time. He is now walking off the field. It probably just aggravated his injury a little more, but it's the Silver Dome, and he'll go off the field on his own accord.
He certainly will, and barring any mistakes now by the St. offense, one first down will seal it for him. There's only 2:05 left in a tremendous play by Brian Cahill. And I didn't see who put the pressure on that quarterback. Did you, Gus?
No,
but he threw a wobbly pass. Tremendous effort by Cahill, who had to dive, kept that ball from being trapped on the surface. Offense, first down, and here comes Frazier.
We said earlier a turnover could be the key. That's what happened there. The Saints have the ball back, a minute 47. Hand off to Steve Becker to the 50, to the 45-yard line. A gain on the play of 8 yards. It'll be second and two. The clock running with a minute 37 left.
Come on, offense. Saints are going to do it. Saints are going to do it without any mistake. Barring a mistake, the Saints are going to be the state Class D championship here in 83, Gus. Come on, Saints, put this thing together.
A first down would clinch it. As time is running out here, a minute 17. It's second and two. If the Saints get a first down, they can fall on the ball, but there's a penalty on the play on St. Ignace. As St. Ignace jumps offside, it'll be second and seven.
Well, you can't blame the offensive line. You don't like to see it at a time like this, especially because it stops the clock, that penalty. But if that offensive line is as nervous and as jittery as we are in a press box, it's a wonder they can even keep their hand down on the ground, let alone know the count. And here we go now. It's second down. It's going to take it back, but we're down to a minute and 12, Don, and they've only got one timeout left. Is that right?
That is correct. One timeout left. They have used two on offense. To be honest, I don't know why the clock is not moving. It should have been moving. Hand off to Oya. First down, safe. That might clinch it. 10 yards, 11 yards on the play for Matt Oya, and that might clinch it.
That should do it. That should do it. That's a first down. That gives us four more plays, and there's no way that Mendon can run out the clock or stop the clock. We can run out the clock, and that should seal it up here. Nice run by Oya off our left side. Give the credit to our left offensive line. That's Brian Toyd over there in number 62, Dale Van Dusen, who opened the way.
First and 10, ball of the Mendon 39. Becker on the run to the 30-yard line, a gain of 9. 45 seconds is all that's left on the clock. Second and one. The Saints, barring unbelievable circumstances, are going to be the Class D state champions.
Well, they are. Saints, I can't see them letting Mendon have it now. It's under 30 seconds and counting. We're down to 25 seconds here at the Silver Dome. And fans up north cheer for the new state Class D champion, St. Ignace Saints.
Hand off, Jim Sobleski, the new man in the ballgame. First down, Saints. Another 5 yards and a first down, and there's only 14 seconds left. And you can count on the St. bus. Timeout, St. Ignace. But you can count on the St. bus coming into town at approximately 4 o'clock on Sunday afternoon. And I know you people will be there in full force welcoming the new 1983 Class D state champion, St. Ignace Saints. And surprisingly enough, they weren't even the UP team of the year.
Oh, no, not the UP team of the year, but the Class D state team of the year, and they're going to be bringing back the gold with them when they come back to the UP tomorrow.
Jubilation on the state sideline. Mendon goes down, but they're a fine ball club. Possibly the best ball club we've seen this year.
Well, they are. There's no doubt about it that they, no reason to see why they didn't make it here. But right now, it's been the state tenacity, and they've just been working for it. They wanted a little worse than Mendon did, Gus. They had, Mendon had the lead, but the Saints wanted it worse, and they never made a mistake. They came right down the field, and now with 14 seconds left, the Saints have a three-point lead and the state championship.
So as for you not to think the Saints are running up the score, the reason for the timeout was to get all the reserves in the ball game.
That's right, and we've got an offside. We have one of our men that lined up over the with the helmet over the ball. 5-yard penalty. The coach Pearson wants to get those boys in there. He wants every member there of that team to be able to say that they played on the state championship Class D team in 83 and played in the Silver Dome, and they're all out there right now.
4 o'clock Sunday. Be there. Parade at the north end of the Mackinac Bridge. Open house at the Zodiac Restaurant. Honor the Saint football team. 5 o'clock to 9 on Sunday night. And then Monday night at 6 o'clock, you'll be able to see the replay of this game if the Saints get another offside penalty.
Well, they've got the youngsters in there, and no real problem there. We've got to just run a play off the clock here, Don. You've got to get these youngsters in there, get their feet wet, and of course, they're probably so jittery like the rest of us there, they probably don't even know the count. But we've got to hold them in there, get one more, two at the most plays off, to be crowned the new state champions. We've got to get a play on off the ground here. Of course, what a game it's been.
It sure has. And we've heard the chant of UP Power coming from the other end of the stadium. This is a tremendous facility. If you ever get in this area, stop and see it. Falling on top of the ball is quarterback Tony Frazier, and Mendon calls timeout. There are 11 seconds left. I want to read down the list of the sponsors that made this telecast possible. The Big Boy Restaurant, Selden's Marathon, Art Husky & Sons, Huron Motel, Driftwood Restaurant & Lounge, McGregor Oil Company, Dave's Red Owl, George's Body Shop, the Collins Motel, Clyde's Drive-In, St. Ignace Automotive, the First National Bank of St. Ignace, St. Ignace Electric, State Bar, the Dwight's Auto Clinic, Brown & Brown Attorneys at Law, Winkleman's Clothing, Statewide Real Estate, McDonald's of St. Ignace, Mackinac Sales, State Rep Pat Gagliardi, UP Snack Foods, Superior Floor Coverage, T&T Electronics, the St. Ignace Truck Stop and Restaurant, Bayside Travel of Petoskey, O'Connell Chrysler, Plymouth Dodge, Belongi Plumbing and Heating, Walker Furniture, the Autobahn. The game is over. The Saints are the Class D state champions of 1983.
Listen to the crowd. Listen to the crowd out there.
We will stay here at the Silver Dome as the awards presentation will be upcoming. Let's recap how this happened. And as I'm doing that, Rick Leedy will see if he looks over our possibilities here. The final score, 15-12, St. Ignace. In the first quarter, Mendon took the lead 6-0 at 6:44. As Tim Jones scored on a 1-yard run, the kick failed. The Saints came back and led 7-6 with 4:30 left in the first quarter. Brian Cahill, a 30-yard pass from Rich Frazier. McPhee added the extra point. Saints led 7-6 at the end of the first quarter and at halftime. In the third quarter, Mendon scored on Steve Shoot, 7-yard run. The extra point attempt failed to score. Mendon 12, St. Ignace 7. And then with 3:16 left in the fourth quarter, Chris Shinsky, a 28-yard pass from Rich Frazier. Brad Erskine added the two-point conversion. Saints win 15-12. Our players of the game, Matt Oya, 11 carries, 81 yards, along with Brian Cahill, a touchdown catch and a winning interception that clinched the victory for the Saints, and Jim Hardy for his fine defensive efforts today. That means both. Bradford, who's taking care of our Player of the Week thing. We have two players who have received Player of the Week honors four times, Pat Lee and Brian Cahill.
Well, that's fantastic. They played a fantastic game. Fantastic. I'm so nervous, I don't know what to say. this is the first time in my life, I think, I've been speechless. But what a game. St. Ignace came here to play ball. And so did Mendon, and it was a fantastic game. I just can't get over how the St. Ignace Saints come back and won this thing.
Well, while they're handing out the awards to Mendon, the Class D runner-up, rated number one all season long, but they weren't number one today.
Well, they had to play a UP Power before they got here. That's why, Don.
We will tell you the answer to our trivia question. The complicated rating system for pro quarterbacks, minimum 1,500 attempts, according to this system, the highest rating of all time, the highest rated quarterback, is presently playing in the NFL, Danny White of the Dallas Cowboys. That's a surprise for you. Coach Barry Pearson carried off on the shoulders of this state football team.
There
he goes. Class D state champ. Winner over the Mendon Hornets, 15-12.
Oh, how sweet it is, Don. How sweet it is.
This was a phenomenal football game. Nip and tuck all the way. Mendon took the lead. The Saints came back. Mendon regained the lead, and the Saints came back and won the game in typical Saints style, winning it in the second half.
That's right, and they never let down. They wanted it worse than Mendon wanted it in the second half. That's the name of that game right there, Gus. Starting from the run back here by Cahill when he dove and head over heels to get a first down on the drive that they scored on. It was all offense. It was all St. Ignace all the way, and of course the defense wasn't about to let them up. So it was just a great win here, and what a year for the 1 year we dropped down to Class D, and what a year it's been, Gus. The place, town has been wild ever since.
We want to see everyone at the parade tomorrow afternoon at 4 o'clock. I'm going to have to get Bo Bradford out of bed early so we can get home by that time. Sometimes that's a tussle.
Well, I don't know about that, but I wonder what's going through the Western UP sports writer's mind right at the present. We weren't good enough to be number one team in the UP, but we're the best in the state.
That makes it kind of sick when you look that way, doesn't it? But there's, look at the players down there laying on the floor down there laughing it up. Some of the seniors, they've been a great squad of seniors. They won't be back, but they've got memories that they will never forget here, Don.
And memories that I will never forget. And this was a phenomenal ball game, one that will definitely go down in Saint history as one that will be remembered for years and years and years. Of course, in 1974, the Saints won the Class C UPI state championship as voted on by the coaches in the state of Michigan, a mythical championship. Although the Saints were 9-0 and had a fierce team that year, of course, that if they had state playoffs, they might have won. But it's different to come down and to prove it in the playoffs, making it in the computer ranking system, and then beating the teams necessary to get here to the Dome and winning it in the Dome. There's no doubt who is the Class D state champion. It's the St. Ignace Saints.
Well, that certainly is true, Gus, and we see all the fans over there. And we just want to hats off to them that made this trip down here. It's a long ways to come. But anyone that made it, boy, they'll be able to tell anybody that couldn't make it. And we feel sorry for those who couldn't. And it's been great. It's been exciting. What a game. It's just wild out here. And boy, oh boy, it's just, my heart is still going about double out here, Don.
Some final thoughts before we close here from the Silver Dome. I'm going to just talk about some players. I'm going to go down the line and hit some that I think had crucial parts in today's game. Rich Frazier, number 10, the head quarterback for the Saints, 3-year starter for the Saints, injured, riddled this year, comes through, down, going in the clutch down the line, a fine performance today, tossing 2 touchdown passes that accounted for our points. A fine career for Rich Frazier. I see Steve Becker. He's going to be back next year. He's the all-state punter. He had 74 yards today in 16 carries, and he has had a fine year. Matt Oya, today's player of the game, all-state honorable mention as a defensive player, a great running back. They'll miss Matt Oya. Brad Erskine had an important part in today's game, came up with some critical first downs and a memorable 2-point conversion as he struggled and put the Saints in the lead for good by 3 points. Brian Cahill, a never-say-die player who plays all the time and with as much intensity as can be expected of anyone. Probably my favorite player on the team. Going down the line, Kyle McPhee, who added an important 1 point and took us into the locker room with a 7-6 lead at halftime. Critical point after, put us in the lead, could have been a tie game. Pat Lee, you have to remember him all year long. He's a sophomore star. He'll imprint his name on many more players before his career is over.
Steady defense. Pat Lee, that's my man.
Jim Hardy, and Brian Toy. I think you can't look at one without the other. They're a pair of defensive ends. When they tried to run against one, they would not succeed and then try and run against the other and not succeed also. They've had great years. Glenn Gibson, the one man in the 61 defense, the middle linebacker. Injury hit him during the middle of the season, but it didn't bother him at all. Glenn Gibson, pop. Paul Getson, sophomore. He's going to be a star for the Saints. He made a critical play as Mendon was driving towards a game-clinching touchdown. He stopped a fake field goal attempt, then was finished off by a few other players. Scott Mitchell, a fine game today for Scott, and he's been good all year long. Jerry Colgrove came up with some crucial pass catches today. Mike Kelly, fine defensive work. Mike almost had an interception. Chris Shinsky, a touchdown pass for Chris today, one that he won't forget as it was the game winner. Andy Brown, a fine game for Andy. He's going to be a star, I think, next year. And the one I think that's more responsible for the Saints' success than anyone else, head coach Barry Pearson. In my mind, the best coach in our conference, the best coach in the UP. He showed it as he outwitted Coach Dick Metlock, who is the dean of high school football coaches in the UP, and he came down here, and his team was ready and defeated Mendon. And Coach Barry Pearson, this has been a long season. You start back in July and August, and now you're done on November the 26th. But a well-deserving round of applause goes to Coach Pearson and his assistants, Coach Sweenor, Brown, Wires, and my pal Super Scout, Bill Adams.
Before you wrap this thing up, I wanted to say one thing. Maybe it was our song that did it, eh? But before they get back on here, I want to say that I thought this was a heck of a football game. The offense, the defense played fantastic. It was just a fantastic football game. And I'd like to say hi to the people back in St. Ignace and let us know what you thought of our song.
Rick, some final thoughts.
Well, Bo's worrying over here. He's...